StarCraft fans! This is Falcon Paladin coming to you with yet another daily Legacy of the Void upload. This is a game between Scream and Sella on Daybreak, the latter edition. In the top right side of the map, we have the Red Terran player. It is Sella! And in the bottom left side of the map, we have the Blue Zerg player. It is Scream, representing SLB, which apparently there's a crest of some kind spinning around his hatchery. This is a high Masters game sent to me at falconpaladin@gmail.com. If you're a Masters level player or GM level player, feel free to send me your replays and I'll probably cast them at this point. All right, looks like no early pull from Scream, which means hatch first, unless he's intending to proxy it right about here, but I haven't seen that for a really, really long time against Terran because of Reapers. And yep, there goes the hatch first from Scream, and looks like a Reaper expand here. We'll go ahead and see how that one's going to hop out here. But yeah, this is High Masters. Again, don't have many of these on the channel. I have a few players that send these in. This is somebody new, actually. This is a new player, and I'm not going to tell you which one of these it is that sent this in to me, because that might give away who it was that won this match, because this is not cast live. Absolutely not. One refinery there from Sella. Barracks going to finish on down here in any second now. And if this player is worth his salt in very high Masters, then he is going to go ahead and do something with it immediately. And the Barracks does indeed make a Reaper. So this is Reaper Ryan. Reaper Ryan was punished for illegally fixing Falcon Paladin's interface by being put in a Reaper suit and sent to fight the Zerg Swarm. Yes, that happened. My interface was broken for a long time. And the guy that made it wasn't willing to help me out anymore. He was kind of, I'm done with that, man. It's all you now. And I was like, ah, man. So I put a request for help on Reddit. And somebody saw that and decided, hey, shoot me an email. I'll help you out. And the email was blizzard.com. So I don't know. Blizzard employee. I kind of did some Googling to see who I could see who it was, but none of them names matched up. So maybe he just has a Blizzard account but doesn't work there. I don't know. I don't know what the story is. But anyway, this is Reaper Ryan. He got punished for helping me fix my thing. What he fixed was this. See in the top right? See this right here? Watch it. Doo-doo. And I can do this now. I could not do that for the longest time. And it really was a problem. Really, really a problem for series when I would cast those. But it's back now. So the times I do cast series, that does increment. And I have this really cool... actually, hold on. Where is that? It's something. There it is. Best of 3, best of 5, best of 9, best of 11, best of 13. All that stuff comes back as well. I don't know how to get rid of that, actually. Is it just here? Series complete and gone. Okay, good. Out. So, we did. Did he just get a... No, the drone... He did actually delay the third base here a little bit, but Slowlings are here now. Oh, he gets the drone kill. Hey-o, Reaper Ryan, nicely done. Nicely done. Getting that drone kill, delaying that third base very nicely. Recognizing these Lings are slow. They can't kill him. They can't kill him off creep. They did made a nice effort. Nice effort from Scream here, but... another drone does barely just get down. Ugh. Great job there getting that drone. Sneaking that drone out there. Using the Lings to kind of zone the Reaper out of the area. Escorting the Ling up here and got it done for the third base. So, that's enough of that. That is enough of that. It looks all the world like we're going to go ahead and see. Unless... Is there not a starport here? There's not a starport. There's the starport. About the 5-minute double medevac drop. Full of Marines over here on the Zerg player. He should know this is coming. He's probably seen this 100 gajillion times before. And should be prepared for it. He does have Slowlings bouncing around. He has quite a few of them. Well, 6, I guess. He made 6. Made 6. Hasn't lost one yet so far, which is always good news for him. Moving in, Reaper Ryan to this natural base. Getting a scout off. Getting shot at by Queen. Coming into the main base, getting a scout off, getting shot at by Queen. I mean, that's kind of how this works, right? Kitty 8 charge, boosh, knocking all those drones away. At the very least, you're knocking down mining time off of the Zerg's attempt. And did he go? No, he almost got a drone. Did he get a drone kill there? He did. He got another drone kill there. Nicely done. Oh, but then Queen kills him. Sorry, Reaper Ryan. Nice try there. Nice try there. Lings tried to run up this ramp, but just got brutally murdered. Two of them. Try to get up there, but there are a bunch of Marines at the top. And I guess that information was important for Scream to have because you don't know for sure that it's coming. Sure, there's a good chance that it is, but scouting is always nice. And he doesn't really have a Sloverlord in position to scout that either. I don't know why he doesn't have one on the top left of the base of this main for Sella, but perhaps he has other things on his mind, like losing drones. Losing drones is always a bad, bad feeling, but he's okay. I mean, it's 54 to 35 Harvesters right now. Scream is way up. Way up in worker count. And if this was something where he was planning at somebody like Polt, it'd be about 5 minutes. These medevacs would be coming in, and I don't know what he would have to stop that, as currently he has 4 Zerglings and 2 Queens, and he's making 3 more Queens and making 24 Lings. There you go. All right, so he's fine. He's making 24 Lings. He's up on his opponent big time in worker count on these 3 bases. He's actually just oversaturated on his third, just a tiny, tiny bit. That should change if he does get extractors here at his third base, so nothing to worry about there. Sala actually unloading his Marines way away from that third base, like just so far away. Gonna walk him down and tap this left Zalunga Watchtower. Doesn't even tap the Zalunga Watchtower. Just try to see if there are some Lings there to murder, I suppose. Spread and creep. Got a bunch of Queens here. Got a Lings here. We've seen this before. We've seen this. Who was that? What was that game that I cast? Can't remember who it was, but it was... I think it was Maru versus Solar on this map. Maybe go back and watch it. Search for Maru on my channel. Not many of those games, and a couple of them have been against Solar, but only one on Daybreak so far. So the Marines on the edge of this creep, I don't know if they want to come in here. There's a lot of Lings, and there are 4 Queens ready to go. Lings overextending just a little bit. Queens need to focus down those medevacs. Are they doing it? Kind of, yes. Getting some good hits off on that one medevac. Oof! Forcing it to get out of there with 14 hit points to her name. Just escaping again. All this does, the idea is not necessarily to kill the Zerg player with these early attacks. The idea is to force Lings out. If Scream had not been forced to make 20 Lings there, that would be another 10 drones that he'd be up on Sala right now. So just forcing Lings out, forcing Queens out, and forcing him to use Larva and Minerals for things other than drones is what you want to do. Here's a Terran player making a macro hatch at his third, actually. Good to see that from players at this high level. It just, people sometimes don't feel like they need macro hatches, but in Legacy of the Void, it can be very difficult to keep up with all of the income that you get so quickly in this game. If your injects are not perfect, a macro hatch is a good way to go. So what do we got? Marines. Moving, tapping that left Zalunga Watchtower again. Another drop full of Marines and a Widowmine moving in to this main base. Again, Sporecrawler positioning. We've seen that before as well. Another attack here at the edge of the creep moving into the third base. The creep is spreading, though, and Scream is playing this extremely well. Now, to these medevacs, do they want to come in here and get hit by this Sporecrawler is the question. This Overlord, Sloverlord for Scream is scouting this perfectly, but the Lings are not coming back to defend this whatsoever. So Sporecrawler getting some nice shots off. Queen getting some shots off as well, but dropping a lot of Marines here. And there are the Lings coming in now. Plus one attack on these Marines, but there are so many Zerglings. Sporecrawler, Widowmine. Widowmine gets 4 kills there. Both medevacs are still alive, very happily alive at this point in time. Might try to swing up here into the natural base. There's no anti-air there, except for that Queen. Small group of Marines on the edge of this creep, trying to pick off creep tumors, and they do get them. They do, and a Queen here as well. Dropping into the natural base is Sala with another drop. The multi-pronged attacks are looking great right now. Queen's not focusing down that medevac as they should here on the edge of the creep, and the Marines in the back of this natural are just going to town before they're forced to pick up by the arrival. A Liberator shows up at the third base but drops right on top of a Sporecrawler and gets murdered. Another Liberator on top of another Sporecrawler. Dude, Sala! No. This Sporecrawler is absolutely super happy. Boosh! 2 Liberator kills on that Spore. Gorgeous play. Just good positioning with Sporecrawlers. I'd like to see one at the natural, but I don't know, harder to get to. Infestation Pit and Aspire coming in. Baneling Speed coming up as well for Scream. Third base trying to be landed by Sala. But there are Lings here. There are Lings here. Oh, and these transferring SCVs getting massacred. Boosh, boosh, boosh. And actually another one gets killed surrounding these units. Widowmines are going to fire possibly. And Friendly Fire killing more Marines than Lings there. But an Overlord explodes spectacularly. Lings forcing a liftoff at this third base. Who wants to come save it is the question. Not enough Marines to do that. That's for sure. Here they come. Now, some Widowmines and Marines do have the bravery to come down and shoot away these Lings. Large, fairly large group of Lings, to be fair. To be fair, they're plus one as well, but not enough to deal with this many Marines. I don't think they lost a single Marine in that encounter. And the third base can land in peace. Dropping down some barracks to wall this off. It is a large area to wall off, a bunker in there as well. But the fourth base is up and running for Scream. He's got creep tumors spreading all over the place. Drop coming back in. Sala, being patient, man. Trying to land. There are Banelings and there are Lings here, and there is a Queen here. I don't know if he wants to drop. He is actually dropping. He's dropping out of the range of those Lings and those Banes, but they're coming over now. Lings trying to get right on top of those dudes. The medevac forced to pick them up and retreat them, although 1, 2, 3 Marines do get killed in the process. The other medevac just goes home. There's really nothing in her to speak of. And medevac moves on back down. Says, if I stay here long enough, perhaps the Zerg will forget that I exist. But 14 Mutalisks on the way. A Hive coming in for Scream as well. This is gorgeous play out of Scream. I mean, this is, he is rebuffing most of these attacks. He's lost some drones. He's lost 13 drones, which is nothing to sneeze at. But really, he's up 76 to 56 harvesters, 20 total workers. He has the ability to go Ling Bling Muta. His creep spread is like nothing I've ever seen. Okay, for a long time, I think I've seen this good of creep spread. And especially to see it at the master level is very nice indeed. Mutas did pick off that medevac hanging around by that main base. And here come the Marines and the Widowmines. Marines, Widowmines, and medevacs here. One queen does get taken down. Widowmines are burrowing at the front. Here come the Marines, brave as can be, trying to force cancels on those Banelings. Nope. Widowmine fires, though, taking out huge groups of Lings and Banelings. Baneling splash on those Marines. Not enough to kill them with one, but guess what? More are coming and forcing a pickoff and a retreat. The Mutas are picking off those units as they're flying away, and everybody gets cleaned up. Oh, cleaned up so hard right there. 166 to 110 total supply in favor of our Zerg player. Terran player continuing with the Marines and the Widowmines. What else is he working on here today? Plus one armor as well. Mutas kind of flying around the front. Lings and Banes flying around the top. Widowmines are firing and catching so many Banelings, though. Oh my gosh, it's so many Lings. 7 kills on that one. 11 kills on that Widowmine. 5 there. 5 there. And those Widowmines might have turned the tables. Meanwhile, there are Mutas in the main base going after add-ons, greatly slowing down the production of Marines by our Terran player, Salah, which is not great to see. Killing up to Marines that are popping out of here as well. Just wrong place, wrong time, man. Can you imagine finishing your training? They're like, all right, time to go out into the great wide world and see what you can do for the Terran army. And there are like 13 Mutalisks over your head and you just die immediately. What a waste of training. What a waste of training that is. So Widowmine's keeping Salah alive there. I really think it's not for these dudes. He might have just lost his third base entirely and just lost the game. So we will see what can happen for a Terran player. Muta's flying back on in. This harassment has been absolutely gorgeous. Just beautiful here, coming around all over the place. Got some more Mutas trying to join their friends, but they probably get picked out of the sky based on the route they're taking. And yeah, they do. They die pretty quickly. Mutas flying on in. Widowmine shots, though. Oh, nice big Widowmine shots, killing a few more units there. How many Mutas have been killed? 8. 8 total, plus 3 ground armor on the way, and plus 3 melee attack on the way for the Zerg player. Looks like we're going to go for some Ultras eventually. Ultralisk eventually. Does he have an Ultralisk cavern? He does not, but it looks like he's planning on it. Although he's got 36 Lings on the way and 6 Mutas. So Lingling Muta seems to be the plan for the near future. Try to spread more creep. And again, what this creep does, gives you vision, gives your unit speed, and just gives more area that the Terran player is afraid to go onto, is what it turns out to be. So Lings right on top of these Marines and Marauders getting massacred, though. Plus 2, plus 3 is done on these units. Wow. Very scary Marines and Marauders right now, pushing right on in, killing so many creep tumors. Widowmine at the front as well, just waiting more attacks. 42 Lings on the way for our Zerg player, but no, fourth hatch dies in record time. More tumors dying. This creep spread is going to be pushed back for days. For days. A fifth base is coming up at the top left for Scream, but he needs to deal with his army first of all. Mutas, are there enough Mutas to do this? There are a lot of Marauders on the ground, and I think there might be enough Mutas to take down what is left here. Widowmine fired. I actually got some more friendly fire there, as it turns out. So some more Widowmines coming in. Some more reinforcing Marines coming in as well. Banelings going to get fired on. Oh, what? 35 dead Banelings right there. Yeah, Marines trying to get rid of medevacs, trying to get rid of the remaining Marines here. But there are so many Marines on the ground. Oh, that plus 3 attack. The Mutalisks are doing their best to clean them out and actually winning fairly handily. Again, the Marauder count a little bit too high, I would say, for Salah. If he's going to deal with this, he really... Another Widowmine shot. Dude, you got to clear these out. You got to clear these out. How many Overseers do you even have? 2. He's got 2. I mean, at this point where the player opposite you is definitely going for a lot of Widowmines. I mean, more Overseers would not hurt. I'm just going to say that. He still hasn't cleared this one out. Scan here reveals the 4th base has not been replaced by the Zerg player. 5th base is being saturated now, and a 4th base is landing for Salah just to the left and up of his 3rd. Here come the Marines. Here come the Marauders for Salah, trying to push forward and see what they can do. And the answer is kill more creep tumors, which is always fine. As a Terran player, you just want to kill those creep tumors whenever you possibly can, because again, vision for the Zerg is bad. Speed bonus for the Zerg is bad. Lings coming right on top of these units. Mutas coming in too. Banelings are a little bit late to the party, but should get some nice hits off. Pretty good splits. Widowmine firing again. The hero of the day, but all the Marines are gone except for three of them. There are enough mutas to get rid of three Marines. More Widowmines firing on a single unit, but killing medevacs out of the sky. 10 medevacs have been killed so far. There are only three in the air right now for Sala. Mutalisks going to town in this main base, killing add-ons once again, going after reactors. It does slow down the macro potential of the Terran player fairly handily. As it turns out, a couple missile turrets chase them away, reinforcing Marines chase them away as well. We're looking at 108 to 153 total supply. Scream is definitely up. Definitely up in this one. Is this Widowmine going to get more Mutalisk kills? Boosh! Yep! Dude, there's the over. Finally! Widowmine over here on the edge of the fourth base has been killed. Scream has replanted his fourth base. It's just about complete. Here comes yet another attack out of Sala. He is down about 30 supply to his opponent. 75 to 47 workers, though, means the army supplies are probably pretty even right about now. About 19,000 for the Zerg player and about 15,000 for the Terran on army supply. Moving on in, threatening this fourth base once again. Lings, Bling, Muta. Another Widowmine shot. The Widowmines are just doing tons of work for our Terran player right now. Lings and Banes trying to make connections. Absolutely steamrolling Marauders. And Marines left on the ground. A small drop here at this fifth base with Marines. Again, plus three Marines are heroes. They are action heroes after the stylings of John McClane. Mutalisks come in, take out the medevac, and that means the Marines are less supported, and they do eventually all get cleaned out there. So, continuing to push is Sala, recognizing he cannot go home. He cannot just let the Zerg player do whatever he wants. Another Widowmine attack there, taking out several Banelings. 43 Banelings have just died in this game. More attacks with Lings, Banes chasing these units home. Widowmines firing all over the darn place. And this fourth base is under attack by Lings. Are there enough Marauders to chase them away? Mutas need to assist with this. Mutas need to assist with that. But no, too many Marines possibly. And actually, Sala manages to defend his fourth base quite well there. He did lose some SCVs. 21 SCVs have been killed to 20 drones. So pretty even on that count. But he is down by like 20 workers, 26 workers to a Zerg opponent. I mean, it's just, you know what? If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Says Sala. Marines, Marauders, Medevacs, Widowmines is the prescription of the day. He did make a couple Liberators, but they died fairly spectacularly. And he hasn't made any more sense then. Not anymore sense then whatsoever. So here we go. Marauders in the front. Marines coming through again, trying to kill more of these creep tumors. He's killed 55 of them. And every time he comes back, there are more, it seems. So there are Banelings ready to go. I think they're a little bit gun-shy about these. He's not gun-shy about these Widowmines. Sending a couple. There we go. A couple units in to trigger the Widowmines. And now it's time to go, but he's not actually engaging at this point. Another Widowmine is set up behind the two that have already gone off, though. And a fifth base landing from Salha. I keep saying Sala, but it's probably Salha. A little bit more of that. I don't know. Very difficult to say indeed here. So pushing on in, killing more creep tubers is our Terran player, Salha. Another drop sneaking up to this fifth base. Still no static defense. Still no queen at this fifth, which I find very odd. Indeed, the Marines end up dropping there and a push on the fourth base at the same time. Unit split for Scream. Widowmines just absolutely not giving a care about these Baneling counts. Not at all. Fifth base attack does get cleaned up by the Lings and the Blings and the Mutas, but 26 drones have died to 21 SCVs. Have lost their lives at this point as well. So what are we looking at here? It's just more of the same, ladies and gentlemen. If you're a fan of this strategy from Return Player, you will be happy. Scream has not actually found the time to go for Ultras at any point here. The pressure by Sala has just been so consistent. More Baneling hits on top of Marauders. Another big time Widowmine shots on these Mutalisks. And you know what? It's suddenly 126 to 130 to 121 total supply. Fourth base falls again with a handful of very injured Marauders. And Marines trying to protect their retreat. Widowmine's firing all over the place. 7 kills on that Widowmine. Another Widowmine. The Muta count is dropping precipitously. 44 Mutas have died in this game. There are only 3 remaining. Somehow, it is 111 and 95 total supply. And Sala is in control of this game. His 5th base is up and running. His 4th base is happily running as well. Not getting much gas income because he doesn't really need it. Has idle SCVs back here. That is third, which is a bit of an annoyance. But again, he's doing okay. He's doing all right. Another attack here up at this fifth base. What does Scream have to stop this? He's got 3 Mutas, a Baneling, and 29 Zerglings. And that's enough. That's it. Good game. Well played. Out of Scream. Scream is defeated. And Salha is victorious. Oh, wow. That was a good one. That was a good Masters level ZVT, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I did casting it, because that was just some great back and forth action. Salha down 20 plus workers, down a ton of army supply, down a couple bases, just kept going at it. Marines, Marauders, Widowmines, I think the heroes of this game. I mean, they, of all the Mutalisks that died in that game, I feel like at least half of them were killed by Widowmines. And the Baneling deaths, 59 Baneling deaths. Resources lost here. Look at that difference there. That is 26 plus 7, 33,000 resources lost for the Zerg player and only 25 for the Terran. It makes sense, almost doubling the gas of the Terran player. Just so many dead Banelings, so many dead Mutalisks. The pressure was just insane. Salla didn't have that much left at the end, mind you. 18 Marines, 11 Marauders, and 4 Medivacs, but he had more than the Zerg player did, and that's all that really mattered. So great job. Mind out for the Zerg. Fifth base, only thing that was mining, under assault by Marines. Fourth base, not even done yet, and two mining bases for the Terran. And that was it. He tapped out. So that's going to be it from me. This has been Falcon Paladin coming to you with yet another daily Legacy of the Void upload. Go ahead and hit that like button. Hit the subscribe if you like what you saw and what you heard today. You can also catch me on Twitter, Facebook, and Patreon, all at @FalconPaladin. And until next time, as always, thank you so much for watching, and you take care of yourself.